Hey, it's time for church. Woohoo!
Boys and girls, thank you so much for joining me here today. My name is Mr. John, and as always, what was that? No, you guys were saying something. What? There's a hat on my head.
Yeah!
Are you sure?
Yes!
How sure? Oh, look at this. There's a hat on my head. Well, I like wearing hats. Well, boys and girls, my name is Mr. John, and as always, I want to start our time by asking you how you're doing today. So, boys and girls, how you doing today? Awesome, awesome, awesome. I'm going to take my hat off. I was just being silly. I hope you guys laughed, because I like being silly. Well, hey, anyways, thank you again for being here. We got an awesome time plan for you. We have been studying the life of Jesus. And Jesus, we know, is the miracle worker. He does a lot of cool things, does a lot of cool miracles. And we've seen some things he's done. Last week, Jesus calmed this storm. He showed his power over the wind and waves. And this week, we're going to see another story about Jesus feeding a bunch of people. Before we get to that, boys and girls, we're going to worship together. So would you stand to your feet? Miss Erica is going to join us now, and she's going to introduce our worship for today.
I'm so excited that we are in this unit learning about the things Jesus did while he was here on earth. And I'm so excited that we're singing songs. We are singing actually the same song every week, Miracle Maker, because this just reminds us that while Jesus was here, he was fully man, but also fully God, and he did all these amazing miracles. We're going to learn about another one today. Our second song today is called Great Things, and this is just praising God because he's done great things. Jesus did amazing things while he was here on earth. And that proved to us that he is fully God, and we can praise him for who he is. So boys and girls, I hope you stand up on your feet and you enjoy singing these songs from your heart to the Lord.
us again to worship God and learn from His Word. Singing worship songs really helps me focus my heart and my mind on God. These worship songs help me think about how great God is and the great things that He has done. And when I think about how great He is, it really makes me want to know Him more. A couple of ways that we can know Him more is by reading His Word and seeing what He has to say to us. And the other way is we can talk to Him in prayer. We can talk to God anytime and anywhere, like He's with us right here. So let's do that now. Dear God, You are a great and mighty and all-powerful God, and yet You are with us right here. You have given us the Holy Spirit that is with us always. When we're scared or afraid, we can trust that You will be our comfort and peace. When we're worried about things we need, we can trust that You will provide for all of our needs. And when we feel lonely or lost, we can trust that You are with us and You will guide us. God, please help these kids put their trust in You alone and follow Your leading in their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, hey, boys and girls. Have you ever thought about how crazy some of the stories are in the Bible? Like, if somebody just told me one of these stories, I might not believe them. But I know that if the story is in the Bible, it's part of God's Word. And I also know that God can't lie. So everything in the Bible has to be true. I also know that these stories that we're hearing about Jesus doing miraculous things were written down by people that were actually there and witnessed these miracles that Jesus did, things that only He could do because He was the Son of God. Our story last week was written down by Matthew, Mark, and Luke. And they told us about a time that they were out in the sea, being tossed back and forth in the wind and the waves. They thought they were going to die. They woke up Jesus, and He told the storm to be calm and silent. And the storm obeyed Him. This week's story is found in the books written by Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. They tell us about a time when Jesus fed thousands of people with just 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. I'm pretty sure my family could eat all of that for dinner. Let's watch our story and see if you can figure out how Jesus did it.
Jesus' disciples had been hard at work. They had been healing people and teaching them. So many people came and went that the disciples did not even have time to eat. So Jesus said to them, "Come with me. Let's go to a quiet place where we can be alone and get some rest." Jesus and his disciples got into a boat to cross the Sea of Galilee, but many people saw them leaving. The people traveled by foot and they ran ahead of Jesus. When Jesus and his disciples got to the shore, the people were already there waiting for them. Jesus saw the crowd, and He cared about them because they were like sheep who needed a shepherd. So Jesus taught the people many things about God's kingdom, and He healed people who were sick. By this time, it was late in the day. Jesus' disciples came to Him and said, "We are out in the middle of nowhere, and it's getting late. Tell the people to go away so they can go to the farms and villages to buy themselves something to eat." But Jesus said, "They don't need to go away. You give them something to eat." Jesus' disciples were confused. "We can't feed this many people," they said. "It would cost a whole year's pay to buy enough bread for them to eat," Philip said. Jesus asked, "How many loaves of bread do you have? Go look." Jesus' disciple Andrew said, "A boy here has 5 loaves and 2 fish, but what good will that do for so many people?" Jesus told the disciples to instruct everyone to sit down. So all the people sat down in big groups on the grass. Jesus took the 5 loaves of bread and the 2 fish. He looked up to heaven, and then he blessed the bread. He broke it into pieces and gave it to the disciples. He also divided up the fish. The disciples passed out the food to the people, and everyone ate until they were full. Then Jesus told the disciples to collect any leftover food. The disciples collected 12 baskets full of pieces of bread and fish. Jesus fed about 5,000 men that day, plus women and children. By feeding the 5,000, Jesus provided for the physical needs of the crowd. The next day, Jesus called himself the bread of life. Only Jesus is able to satisfy our souls forever by providing forgiveness, peace with God, and eternal life.
Boys and girls, in our story today, Jesus does this amazing, awesome thing, where he takes 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish and he feeds 5,000 people. It was actually more than that, they say, with the women and the children. So all these people Jesus feeds with just 5 loaves of bread and a few fish, and he takes care of them physically, right? We need food, and these people needed food, and Jesus provided that for him. And that brings me to our big picture question. Our big picture question is, why did Jesus perform miracles? Jesus performed miracles to glorify God and to show that he is the Son of God, and to care for people. Obviously, in our story today, Jesus cares for people. He feeds them with physical food. But boys and girls, Jesus is so much greater than that. He came to provide for us spiritually, to make us whole. When we read his word, when we pray to him, he means to fill us up spiritually. Remember when he was tempted and he said, "Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word of God." Boys and girls, we need spiritual food. We need the Bible. We need Jesus to fill us with that spiritual food from his word. And this brings me to our key passage. Our key passage is Psalm 40, verse 5. "Many, Lord my God, are the wonders you have done, the things you have planned for us. None can compare with you." Boys and girls, Jesus has done amazing things. When he died on the cross and he rose again, boys and girls, you and I have salvation. We have freedom today. And we have a spiritual food that we need so we can know God and live for him. And this verse reminds us of that. We have a song we've been singing to help us memorize this. So would you join me now as we sing that together?
Thank you.
All right, boys and girls, our Bible story was incredible today. Jesus fed so many people with just a few loaves of bread and a couple fish. That's crazy. It shows us that he is truly God and that he is the miracle maker, like we sung about a couple minutes ago. Boys and girls, to help you remember our Bible story this week, I want you to make lunch with or for your mommies and daddies. I think this will be really good because Jesus saw that the crowd was hungry and he wanted to feed them, and he did this amazing thing. And so I know that some of you are more than capable of making lunch or helping make lunch. You can see that your family's hungry and help. And as you guys eat that lunch together, I want you to tell each other the Bible story one more time. I want you to remind each other of what Jesus did as you eat your grilled cheese or chicken nuggets or peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, because it's good to share what Jesus has done and to remind each other of those stories. So good luck, be safe, and have so much fun. We'll see you next time.
What a great idea, Miss Erica. Boys and girls, make some food for your moms and dads. I'm sure they'll appreciate it. Provide for their needs spiritually. And remember that as many of you I know are starting school or you have started school, as you go into your schools, remember you have spiritual food. You know Jesus and you can give that to others as well. Boys and girls, thank you for joining me here today. I have loved hanging out with you. I hope you're having an awesome day. I hope you're having an awesome week. And I look forward to seeing you again next time. Bye, boys and girls. For more information, please visit us online at wellspringcc.org/kids. There you can sign up for our newsletter, which contains resources to help you lead your kids and disciple them at home.